Hey guys, welcome back to another video here on the Juice Reacts channel. We are reacting to season one, episode number 9 of the High School Musical, the musical, the series. This time it is opening night. I am super excited. Opening night here. We are on episode number 9, which means we only have this episode and episode 10 left in season 1. Then we jump to season number 2, which is arguably the worst season. It is the worst season out of the 3, and it's got a lot bad. It's got a lot going against it. But there's some moments in there that we'll get to when we react to those episodes that are good. There's some good moments in season 2. There are. Just the overarching plot and the overarching themes of season 2, they don't really go over so well in the HSM TMTS community. So we'll get to all that when it happens. But we've got act number 1 of opening night for the High School Musical production, which is where they're doing High School Musical 1. And I'm super excited. In the last episode, we had tech rehearsal where we found out that, we already knew, but the rest of the people found out that Courtney actually has a great voice, which is, yes, she does. She's got one of the top 5 voices, top 3 voices in all of the show. And they went to the, what was it called? The El Rey Theater. They went to the El Rey Theater, and it was just a bad place to be. It hadn't been used in like over 4 years or something like that. And it was just all in all a bad spot. Ricky and Nene almost kissed when they were rehearsing their lines, which is just like, I'm not here for it. I will admit that when I very first watched the show, when I first ever watched season 1, I did not mind Ricky and Nene when they were going like and getting, that was the plot, when they were going to get together. I didn't mind it. But I was also probably more in favor of Ricky and Gina back in season 1 when I first watched it. And then we got to season 2 where Ricky is just like this whole different character. His whole personality, both him and Nene's whole personality in season 2 is their relationship. Like, you never want to have people in real life, let alone characters on a TV show, where their whole personality is the each other in their relationship. That's not good at all. So like they completely changed and messed up Ricky, his character. Then they redeemed themselves in season 3, where Ricky's character was the best character on the show, probably, in that season. Carlos was also there, and Courtney were also really good characters in that episode, in that season too. But and Gina, obviously. But in season 1, I was I probably was leaning more towards Ricky and Gina than Ricky and Nene. And then season 2 came around, and Ricky and Nene, spoiler alert, are together. if you're watching this reaction series and you haven't seen the show and this is the first time you're watching it is with me reacting to it, I apologize. I didn't mean to spoil anything for you, but I've seen the show a million times. I'm assuming that all of you guys watching it have seen the show a million times too. So that's why I'm kind of spoiling some things. So season 2 kind of gets weird, and then you get the whole EJ Gina plot line, and then you get to season 3 and it just goes from there. So the fact that in last episode, Ricky and Nene almost kiss, and then knowing what I know, it's just, I don't know. I'm always going to be an Arena. That's just who I am. I'm an Arena fan. I am 100% on board with Ricky and Gina. That's what I am. I am so excited for season 4 to see what happens with them, but from season 1, I probably was leaning a little bit more towards Ricky and Gina than Ricky and Nene. So they almost kiss, and then we know what happens in episode 9 and 10. So we'll get to that in a second. So episode number 9, opening night. I'm so excited. I hope you guys are too. If you want to leave your comments down below in the comment section, and you want to talk about anything that's going on with the show, your opinions, your thoughts, your predictions for season 4, I would love to hear all that stuff. So yeah. If you want to have some conversations, also I have the World of Juice Discord link down below in the description. If you want to have more in-depth conversations outside of the confines of the YouTube comments section, where we can be a little bit more involved with each other, then we can certainly do that. So yeah, without further ado, I think it's time to watch season 1, episode number 9 of High School Musical, the musical, the series. Let's get to it.
Try your on. do this.
What?
So this is for Gina? I thought she moved away.
She did. The day after she missed tech rehearsal.
Ricky never says that the song isn't for Gina.
The song is for Nini.
He just says that it's for Nini. He doesn't say it's not for Gina.
Opening night gift. I'm sure Ricky's gonna give me something too.
She's getting him an opening night gift? What are we talking about here?
You've come a long way and
haven't stopped thinking about your sound check. You have the best voice in Northern Utah.
She does have the best voice in Northern Utah.
And then there's like 100 emojis. How am I gonna know the lines?
When I first watched this episode, I thought that Nini was going to be a little bit upset, but it turns out she wasn't. I didn't think she was, but kind of I thought that there might be a little bit.
Savor the solitude.
Savor the solitude, then Ricky comes right in.
Ricky, you're really early.
I know. I just didn't know.
Nothing onto the stage during a regional production of South Pacific. Use it.
Okay. Use it.
Only actor with open.
Do I have to?
Do I have to?
Listen, I'm gonna run. I'll see
oh, the muffin story.
Pre-game. Just take a second, both of you.
Sorry.
I think that was me.
Okay, how many people?
What were they
here?
Doing up there? That sounded like hey. Ashlyn and Big Red. What were they doing up there? Kind of suspicious.
We were all in a really weird place.
That's good, Ricky. Deny her. Keep her at bay. Keep her at arm's length. You want Gina?
It's cool.
Man, Ricky don't know what to do. He's got two women who absolutely just want his body, and he can't decide who. It's obviously Gina. That's Steph, right? Her name's Steph? I'm pretty sure her name's Steph. She's always late.
Our leading lady.
Not for me. Sorry.
Ricky just denies it right away. He's like, not for me. Sorry. Oh, Ricky. It actually is pretty important. He's texting Gina. So.
Hey.
How do I look?
High five from Big Red. Oh, he's the best. She actually does make a really good Miss Darbus. That was a good casting.
We're friends. You know, I don't. We're good.
Are you good, Ashlyn? You don't seem good.
Okay, last touches. Anyone speak now forever?
First of all,
I like Carlos's suit, by the way. I like the flowers. I'd probably rock something similar.
Share then. Oh, and speaking of sharing, Gina sends her love and support to all of you, but unfortunately she's on the East Coast.
Look at how distraught Ricky is because Gina's not there. It's crazy how much he's into her.
If anyone wants to share.
You're my guys and this is our team.
You're my guys and this is our team.
Oh, they will, Ricky. They will laugh at you if you mess up.
Do you ever feel like there's this whole other person inside of you just looking for a way to come?
My nail beds are history.
My nail beds are history.
Kind of cute, too.
So is a mountain lion, but you don't pet it.
We're all in this together.
Yes, we are. We're all in this together. You guys got to remember that. We're all in this together.
Take a moment to settle your nerves.
Hey, you know, I got you back tonight, right?
I mean, I'll have the words in my hands on stage, but I don't know what to do when the maniacs start dancing.
Idol chords.
It's just have fun.
I love how she's freaking out that she can't dance her and Nini were dancing in the alleyway in the homecoming episode.
Getting in character.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
She's getting into character. Sure. Fell in love. With a boy and I can't tell if I fell out. Is it just a part we're playing and it don't feel like we're faking? Just for a moment. Look at the way they're looking at each other, man. It is kind of sweet. Moment enough. When we're underneath the lights, my heart's no longer soaking. I will admit, Just for a Moment is a top tier song. That is for sure.
Here you go, girl.
I think it's first come, first serve.
Why would they be reserved seats at a high school play? Come on. Jeez, Lynn.
Oh.
And by the way, I was just thinking about this. Could they get Ricky any less accurate clothing to what Troy was wearing in the first scene? Because that's not what he was wearing. That would be pretty awkward if the Pledge of Allegiance starts playing. You don't know what to do. You're at a high school play. Do you stand up? What do you do?
I'll tell you what you can do for me.
Perhaps I don't know if you can hear in the background because the scene, I've turned the audio down a little bit, but they're singing. They're singing the start of something new in the background. That doesn't happen this early into the movie. I don't know why they're doing it.
I tried a solo and nearly fainted.
Really? Why's that?
I took one look at all the people staring only at me, and the next thing I knew, I was staring at the ceiling. End of solo career.
Yeah, my showerhead is very impressed with me.
Her delivery is not as good as Gabriella's, but Ricky's is okay with Troy's. They got EJ more accurate clothing than what Ricky's wearing. I mean, yeah, Troy wears a jacket and a plaid shirt or some sort of shirt like that, but not this.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The lake has to cross in the back.
How's it going?
I think she's getting it.
Oh my gosh, just like 100 pounds.
But keep drilling it, though.
That was 2 counts of 8. It would be pretty daunting to go in there and try to learn all the dances the same night.
Yeah. What do you know about Troy Bolton?
This one always confused me because when this scene happens in the movie, they're outside in they're outside. But they're doing it in front of the lockers here. That's not the background. They got it wrong.
However, unlike...
Gotta catch up on homework.
What?
Hello, this scene, the second day back. They're walking in the hallway, Troy and Chad are. But Gabrielle and what's-her-face aren't.
Carlos, this is as far as I
Taylor,
can
by the way, from the last clip. Taylor is her name. I couldn't think of it on the spot there. But stick to the status quo, baby.
This is our biggest...
We could just have Gina do it.
Gina? Yeah, Gina! Woo!
Hi.
Oh my God, what?
I was gonna drop off these cupcakes and then hide in the gym and cheer you guys on.
Gina, no one in the gym wants to hide more than I do right now.
Wait, are you playing Taylor?
I was, and it was not.
Can I?
Of course, you can do it.
Yeah, Gina's back. Let's go, man. Love Gina back. Love having Gina back. And that's a true dancer right there, always being prepared. She had her dance shoes even though she just came back to deliver those cupcakes. That's a true dancer. No, no, no. Stick to stuff you know. Look at Ricky's face when he realizes Gina's back, man. That is the face of a man that's in love. Everybody quiet!
This is not what I want.
This is not what I want. Something is really, something's not right. Really wrong. Seb does a fantastic job as Sharpay. Fantastic job. Why couldn't they get real, like, French fries, or whatever she had, chili fries, to splash on Zeb?
Still can't believe you're actually
Look
back.
At this man. This man can't even speak. He is in love.
Don't blink. Don't miss me.
Or maybe I'm just back to who I always was. I don't know.
No, you're not the same person now that you met Gina, that is for
Didn't
sure.
I think we'd ever see you again.
Just fly, dude.
What?
Oh, he loves her so much. They love each other so much. I can't handle it right now.
5 minutes. Ricky, we need you in your harness pronto.
Gotta go.
Look at the look back. Oh my God. I can't. Gene, you're killing me with that look back. I can't.
Who? Dean.
Who?
From the Youth Actors Conservatory.
Courtney.
That's her. Yeah, her.
Just had to call her.
Pictures are all over their website.
This is your moment.
I originally thought that she was going to be super mad at Courtney for this. I didn't think she'd react that way. I thought she'd be super upset. Alright, here we go. We get some Ricky action now. It's about time. Gotta go wild. Grab and go. Gotta hit the right note. Wait a minute, another time and place. Get my head in the game. Gotta get your head in the game. Gotta get my head in the game. Get your head in the game. Just imagine if Troy did this in the movie. He just, like, floated up in the air. That'd be crazy. This is just utter disrespect. How do you go in knowing that you've never met the kid and kiss his mom when he can clearly see it? Unbelievable. Get my head in the game. Gotta get your head in the game. See, it's funny because he doesn't have his head in the game anymore. See, that's the funny part.
My mom's new boyfriend decided to show up, and I want to punch a wall. I
feel like understandable. That's a very understandable response and reaction to what happened.
Seems a little nervous.
Why? What happened? Excuse me.
What's Ricky thinking here? What's he gonna do? He is clearly shook.
Hey, you need to do the second act.
Yeah, there's Troy. I'm. I'm very aware that Ricky is a very handsome-looking man, but well, it's unnecessary that we need shirtless Ricky at this point.
Will you do it?
Ricky, don't do this. Don't give EJ this glory. Don't do it. He doesn't deserve it. He's not the Troy. And now we're back to where we started the episode, leaving on a cliffhanger. That is not the Troy. That is not my Troy. That is not my Troy, I swear. All right, that is episode number 9, opening night. Some pretty big things happened in that episode. We had Ricky and Nene figuring out if they like each other, kind of like giving that little stare during Just for a Moment, which admittedly is kind of cute. It's kind of adorable. It's better when it's Ricky and Gina, but but Ricky and Nene, to be fair, it is kind of adorable, so... You get that part, then you get Gina returning. The queen has returned to her throne. Thank you, Gina, for coming back and blessing our screens again. Because she's what holds this series together. Her and Josh, Ricky, hold this series together. And her coming back was just, it was just chef's kiss. And then Ricky and her having that little talk before the get your head in the game scene, and the way that he doesn't know what to say because he's just so in shock that she's back and he's fully in love with her, and he's conflicted with him and Nene, and then she says, "You just gotta fly, dude," and then he walks away because he's gotta go get ready for the scene, and then she gives that lingering look back. I mean, you're just stabbing my heart with the arena love. I cannot handle it right now, but I will have to survive because I know what happens in season 3. So... I just gotta endure the pain of season 2 just to get to season 3. And then we get just utter, unbelievable levels of disrespect from Todd. Ugh, can't even say his name without throwing up. Todd. Coming in late, for one, and then kissing your girlfriend, who happens to be the mother of the star of the play, who's up in... the air with the basketball having a solo. You can clearly see him. You came in late, so you know what's going on. You probably looked up on stage and, well, in the, where the stage would be because they're in the gym, but you could see that this boy is in the air and he's singing a solo right now, and you just walk in, you kiss him when you know you've never met him in person. You had one small 30-second phone call with him when he was freaking out, which was another bad thing that he did. And you go and kiss his mom on the cheek or wherever he kissed her on the forehead. I don't know what he did. But to do that, the levels of disrespect, the utter audacity to do that. Unbelievable from Todd. And unbelievable from Lynn to accept it. Unbelievable. I can't handle those two. They are not my people. I do not support Lynn and Todd. I would tell you that right now. But yeah. We've got one more episode left to go. It's episode number 10, the season finale. What's going to happen? We left on a cliffhanger. Ricky gives EJ the role of Troy, which is what EJ's wanted since the beginning of the season. And EJ finally has it now. Is he going to be able to flourish with the role of EJ? Or with the role of EJ? With the role of Troy? Or is he going to crumble under the pressure? How is Nene going to react? Because Nene doesn't know any of this. Like, Nene doesn't know that switch went down. She still thinks that Ricky's Troy. So how is she going to react? How is Miss Jen going to react? What's going to happen with Ricky? Is he going to go and punch Todd in the face? I hope he does, but I know he doesn't. I wish he did. episode number 10, the season finale of season 1 is going to be off the rails. I hope you will join me for episode number 10. But that's going to do it for my episode 9 reaction. Season 1, episode 9, opening night of High School Musical, the musical, the series. If you want to catch back up with any of the parts, previous episodes you may have missed, there's a link down below in the description for the playlist. You can go back and you watch any episode you may want to catch up on, see some of your favorite scenes and stuff. Also, I have a link to my World of Juice Discord. I had to think of what it was called first. My World of Juice Discord, where we can have more in-depth conversations about High School Musical or about Disney movies or like whatever you want to have a conversation about. I'm happy to talk about it without having to like be confined to the YouTube comment section and stuff. But you can also leave your comments down below, and I'd be happy to have conversation with you there, because I love talking about these movies. I love talking about this series. I enjoy it, and I know you guys do too. You wouldn't be watching if you didn't. But yeah, my Twitter's also down there in the description as well if you want to go follow that. I follow a lot of High School Musical themed Twitter accounts that are also in the community that are also fans of the series and of the movies. So if you want to go follow me to see some of that content, kind of keep yourself in the loop for possible season 4 release dates and all that kind of stuff, and just little like tidbits and stuff, then you can follow that and get up to date with all that stuff. So yeah, that's going to do it for episode number 9 of season 1 of High School Musical, the musical, the series. I hope you guys will join me for episode number 10, and then as we go forward with season 2 and season 3, and then obviously with season 4, I'll react to it as well. So yeah, that's going to do it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave it a like. Subscribe to the channel. Join the Juice Club. Thanks for stopping by. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.